Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to work with the assertions in JMeter. So basically, assertion is a kind of a verification point and we can apply on the response. So there are types of assertions are available. So the mostly used assertions are response assertion, duration assertion, size assertion, HTML assertion, XML and XML schema assertions, XPath and JSON assertions. Now we will see how to use these assertions in JMeter. So the first one is response assertion. So the response assertion used in TestScript to validate a pattern in the response body, header, code, message, etc. So there are different pattern matching rules are there to validate the response. Now we'll see practically how to use this response assertions. So let me open my JMeter. So I have a new test plan created. So first step, we need to add a thread, that is number of users. I'm adding thread group. So here I'm giving some name, let's say users, and here number of threads I'm saying, let's say 5 threads, and every 2 seconds I want to execute, and I will execute loop count is let's say 3, right? So once we have created your thread group, then save this test plan. So I'm saving this test plan as my test plan 2. So I already have one. So I'm just say 2 here. So I have just created a thread group with the number of threads, ramp up period and a loop count. And then we need to just create one sampler. Let's go to sampler. I'm taking HTTP request. So let's go to HTTP request. So here we need to specify the application which we are going to hit. So I'm adding open source demo.orangehrmlive.com. So this is the website I'm using. And protocol is HTTP by default it will use. And so this is a URL. So if you want to use path, you can just say slash. So that is your root. So I'm just hitting the get request. So once we have done this, again, the save your test plan. So once we have done this, next one, so we have to create one kind of listener, so that will give you the report. So go to listener here, and here I'm just adding few listeners. The first one is view result tree. So this is a listener, that means it is a report, it will show you. And I will also add one more report, that is another listener, that is a tabular format. So tree we have added. The other one is I can just add one more summary report. There is a tabular report will be there. Yeah, view results in table. So these are the two reports. They are listeners I have added. Now let's execute your test plan. So I'm saving this. And once we save this, just click on this run button. So start, then it will execute our thing. So now you can see the result here. So everything is goes well. So now I got some result here, right? So this is basically, we need to do some setup. Now we'll see how to add assertions to this particular request. So as I said, assertions means a verification points. So what kind of assertions we have, how to add those assertions. So the first assertion I'm talking about is response assertion. So by using this assertion, we can do certain kind of validations on a response. So here, if you just go to users, or you can just go to test plan, right click on this, add, you can see one more option called assertions for this particular test plan. So these are all a list of assertions which are supported by JMeter. So first of all, I'm just taking response assertion. Let's take response assertion. Now it will give you different names. So here I'm just giving response assertion. These are name. So I can just put as a one because I can add multiple response assertions. Every assertion is representing with some name. So response assertion one I am adding. So here you can see different options and main simple and main sample and subsamples, main sample only, subsamples only, JMeter variable name to use. So we'll discuss these options in the coming videos. Now these are the main things we need to use. So field to test. So on response, what are the things we are going to test? So we have text response, response code, response message, response headers, request header. So these are all the different parts of your response. So once you hit the URL, so we can just verify anything here. So first let's start with the response message. So I'm just selecting this response message. So what I'm going to do is in the response, I want to check something. So for example, in the response message, I want to check, let us say, contains. I'm using contains option. And the response message contains. So here we need to add some pattern text here. So we need to just click on add. And now here I'll just say, okay. So means once we get the response should contains a, the response should contains a okay option. So that means response is successful. So this is, I've just created one response assertion. So this assertion will verify our response contains a message is okay or not. So then save it. So once I have saved it, then I'm executing my test plan one more time. Before that, clear all the stuff, then execute our test plan one more time. And this time I will add one more type of listener report here, assertions report, especially assertions results we can see in that particular report. So before running this response assertion one, I'm adding one more, one more assertion. So here add assertion. So here you can see one more type of assertion that is called, So under listener, we have one more type of listener, assertion results. So this will give you the detailed information of assertion statuses. So I'm taking assertion results. I'm just added one more report apart from this response assertion one. So this is basically assertion, and this is a report. Assertion result is a report. So we have a three reports I have added: result tree and result table and assertion results. And we always check this assertion results report after execution of your request. So once you have done this, let's execute your test plan, save your test plan, and then clear everything and then run this one. Now I have run this. Now let directly go to assertion result. Now everything is goes well, HTTP request. So everything is passed. Now if you see the result tree and everything, every request is passed, we just expand this. All the requests are successfully gone. So even assertion results, we don't see any issues. In the table also, we don't see any issues. So everything is goes well. Now what I will do is I'll just modify this one. So instead of okay, okay is there. So now what I can do is I'm just selecting this not option. So previously I've selected contains. Now I'll just modify with the not option. Now what happens? So the response, I'm expecting response should not have okay message, right? So there's a negative testing. So when I run this test now, my result should fail. My assertion should fail because I'm saying not here. So not contains. So again, save it and clear the previous result and then execute one more time. Now observe this. So go to assertion results. Now we can see it is giving an error, failure message. So what it's saying is test failed, message expected, not contains okay. But currently okay is there in the response. So if you want to see the whether response is having okay or not, you can just go to this particular failures. And here you can see response message is having okay. But we are expecting not okay. So that's the reason all the requests are failed here. Okay. So this is a response assertion where I have verified the response contains a proper message or not. Now I'll show you different options. So I will create one more response assertion. So for now, I'm just removing this. Save. So I will create one more assertion. Let's go to plan. Right click, add. Again, I will add same response assertion. And this time I will take another type of assertion. That is, let us say response code. Let's go to response code. So normally if any request is successful, we will get the code as 200. So response code I have taken here. So response code, I'll just say equals, I'm saying now. I'm taking equals operator. Response code equals. And here I need to provide that value. Click on add button here. Then I'll say 200. So 200. So what is my condition here is response code should equals to 200. Okay. So once we added this response assertion, I'll name it as a 2. Response assertion 2. Then save it. Now I have added one more assertion, and in this assertion I'm verifying response code is 200. That's my expected. Now let us execute your plan. So clear the old results. Now execute your plan, start, then go to assertion results. Now everything is goes well. And even if you see the result in a table, everything is successful because status code is 200. And here we can see status code is 200 or not. So if it just says sample result, just take one of the request. Now here you can see response code is 200. So that's the reason all the requests have been successful. So this is another type of response assertion we can create. This is a response code contains a 200. Suppose I can also do the negative testing. Suppose response code contains, I'll just change the number, let's say 101. So this is invalid actually. So or else we can just take not negative. So after modifying this value, I'm again saving my plan, clear all the details, and then I'll execute again my plan. Now you can see this. So I'm just running my test plan. So click on this arrow mark, start. Now it is started. Now we can see it is getting failure because every request is sending response code is 200, but we are expecting 201. So that's a basically mismatch is happened here. So every request. So if you just go and see other results, so here everything is failure. Okay. So this is another kind of a negative testing. So always the response code is 200 if the response, if a request is successful. All right. So I have just again changed it. So this is how we need to verify the response code. So far we have verified two things as part of response assertion. One is response message. The other one is a response code. And I will show you one more response header. So there is one more thing called response header. So how we can verify this? So what is normally response header? So if you just go to result here, view result T, select one of the request, you can see sampler result, right? So I'm verifying response header. So you need to go for response data. And here you can just see response headers. So these are all the different headers we got it from the response. Now we can also verify these response headers. So one of the header is there or not, we can just verify it. So for example, here I'm going to verify something. So here HTTP 1.1 200, okay. So this particular header, response header should have this particular value that I want to verify. So how to verify this? I'll put the response assertion on this particular value, that is response header. So go to plan and I will create one more assertion. So right click, add, again creating same assertion, so response assertion. Now here response assertion 3, and here I am taking response header. So select this response headers. Now here response headers, I'm just taking contains. Now here add and specify the value. So response header should contain this particular value. That is my expectation. And once we have done this, then save your plan and then again go back to test plan, then clear all the results and then execute it. So now go to our assertion results. Now everything is goes well. So all the requests are successful in every report. So everything is goes well because the response header contains a value. Now I'll slightly modify this. So for example, I'm just taking not here. Means I am not expecting this to be there in the response, right? So now this should fail. So save this plan, go to your test plan and execute and click on this arrow mark one more time and clear the previous results and just click on this. Now it is started. Now you can see assertion results. Now it is seeing the test failed. So headers expected not to contain this one. We are expecting not to contain, but this is there in the header, response header. So our requests have failed here. So this is how we can also do some negative testing. I'm removing for now and just saving it. Right. So now clear the result. So these are all different options we can use. So sometimes you cannot text response, request header, request data, and ignore status, or document is contains or not in the response, or URL is sampled is or not. So we can just use different options here. Based upon your requirement. So this is all about the response assertion. So that's the first type of assertion. The next one is size assertion. So basically this particular assertion is used to validate the size of the response with specified value in bytes. So normally whenever we got some response, it having some size. So we have to verify our response size here. So let's see how to use this. So let's go to JMeter again. So I'm just cleaning everything. So here, apart from these response assertions, I will also create a new assertion that is size assertion. So let's go to size assertion now. So how we need to insert, just select the plan, right click, add assertions and size assertion. Select this one. Now in the size assertion, I'll just say one here, because I will also add one more assertion. So in this assertion, size assertion, again, we have a multiple options here. We'll discuss this in the coming video. So here, this is very important. Response size field to test. So we have to check either full response we need to check, or response headers only, or response body only, or response code, or response message. So what is the size we have to verify here? So we have to select one of these. So I'm just selecting full response. And normally, if you want to see the response, how much our report is response. So you can see in the report if you have previous data, but if you don't have, no issues. Just go to size assertion one. Here I'm taking full response. Okay. So I am expecting my response size is 1000, I'm saying. So we need to use one of these operators. It should be exactly 1000, but it never be happen 1000. It will be less than or greater than always, right? So here I'm saying 1000. So let us say less than 1000. So this is my expected. So I'm expecting full response size is 1000 bytes. Okay, let's execute this. Now saving this assertion. And after saving this assertion, okay, so let's go and execute it. So before that, clear everything and then go to plan, then execute, start this button. Now we can go and see the assertion results. Now again, size assertion is failed. See now here, the result was the wrong size. It was this one, 16638 something, but it should have been less than 1000, because we have given only 1000. It should be less than 1000, I'm expecting. But the response size is exceeding 16. Every response size is exceeding 16, right? So this is our expectation. So it is getting failure. Now what I will do is I will just change the value. So I'm expecting it should be less than 2000. It should be less than 2000. So again, save this and clear all the previous result. Now again, execute our plan. So I'm just executing one more time. So now we can see assertion results here. So again, it is getting failure. Now we'll see why it is getting failure. So again, it is giving 16,000. Sorry, it is not 16,000, right? So every size of the response is crossing 16,000, but here we have just given only 2,000. So again, it is getting failure. So I will just modify this again one more time. Just go to this assertion. Size assertion, instead of 2000, I'll just say 20,000. Okay, 20,000 I have given. So 20,000 should be less than, our response size should less than 20,000. Now save this again, clear the old result, and then execute one more time. Now go to see assertion results. Now everything goes well. So all the requests are going well. Now if you go and see the result, the view result tree, expand this one, so every response is fine. So if you go result table, here you can see the type size here in the bytes. So all the requests and responses, all the response sizes around 16,000 plus, everything is below 20,000. So my request is passed. So this way we can also verify the response size in each and every request, so by using size assertion. All right, now the next we'll see duration assertion. So far we have discussed two types of assertion: response assertion, size assertion. Now I'll show you one more assertion, that is duration. So add assertions and go to duration assertion. So what is the use of duration assertion? So the duration assertion is used to validate that the sampler request gets processed within a specified amount of time. So I need to specify some duration, and my response should complete, or my request should complete or process within that particular time, and then my test is passed. Suppose my response is taking long time, more than the time I specified, my test will be failed. So let's see how we can use duration assertion. So here I have created a duration assertion. So here I'm saying duration assertion. So I'm just say one here, duration assertion one. And here again, you can see, you can also add some comments if you require, but they are optional. Again, applies in three different levels, main, sample and subsamples, main sample only, subsample only. Again, I'm just skipping this one to the next videos. So here we need to give some time, how much time we have to specify here. And within that time, our we should get the response. Okay. So here I will say 1000 for now. Duration in milliseconds, I say only 1000 milliseconds and save it. Right. So save it and then clear the old result and then go to plan and execute it. Now go to assertion results. Now everything is failing. Let's see why it is failing. So because the operation is lasted too long, it took around 1702 milliseconds or 709, 738, almost 1700 or 1600 range is there. So this much time it is taking every request, but we have specified maximum is 1000 milliseconds. So that's the reason our requests are fail here. Then I'll just modify my time. So just go to duration assertion. So everything is almost together 1000 plus, right? So duration assertion, I will just make it as a 2000, right? Now again, save it, then clear the old result, then execute one more time. So I executed, now go to assertion results. Now everything is goes well. So this time it is taking, response time is always less than our specified time in the duration assertion. So everything is passed. Go to result table. Now here, the table we haven't see here, but go for the tree view. Just expand these request. So under response, we can see that. So the response, this is your response data, or somewhere it should display how much time it is taken, but no issues. Let's select this one. Okay, so it will show you all the data or response. So we have whatever time we have given. So within the time, we have got the response. So that's the reason all our requests are passed here. So this is a another kind of assertion, that is duration assertion. So the next one is HTML assertion. So the HTML assertion is used to check the HTML syntax of the response. So normally some request will give you HTML form of response. So whenever you got the HTML form of response, you have to validate the HTML structure, whether it's proper HTML or something wrong in this HTML format or not. So that also we can verify. So what I can do is I can just create one more assertion here. Go to plan, right click, add, go to assertions, and here I'm selecting HTML assertion. So in the HTML assertion, here we have to specify, we are two formats, HTML, XHTML or XML. We can verify all these formats. So currently my request will send back the HTML. So I'm just selecting HTML. So when I say HTML, so when I run this code, when I run this assertion, what happens is this particular assertion will verify our request will sending the proper HTML response or not. Every HTML format is there. Whatever response we are getting, that should be in proper HTML format. It will verify that. So first let's execute this. I'm not putting anything here. I'm saying just error threshold is zero, warning threshold is zero. I'm just for now, I'm just passing 00. Okay, let's see after executing what will happen. So 00 I have saying error threshold is zero, warning threshold is zero. Basically this particular assertion will verify or validate the HTML response. Now save it and clear the previous result and then execute my test plan. Select the test plan, run this or start it. Now go to assertion result, assertion results. Now it is failing. Now you can see. So HTML assertion TD parser error and one allowed is zero. And here warnings are six, allowed is zero. So what it is exactly representing is, it is basically focused on two things. One is errors, the other one is warnings. So our HTML is giving one error and six warnings in our HTML response. So one error, six warnings, but what I have given threshold point default 00. So what I should do, I'm expecting here is in HTML format or in HTML file, in response HTML file, I am expecting it should not have any errors. That means zero errors and zero warnings. That's what I'm expecting. But in the exact HTML file, in the response HTML file, there is one error. There is six warnings are there. So that's the reason my assertion is failed here. So if I want to pass, what I can do is I can just specify the threshold point. So here there is one error and six warnings are there almost in every request, right? So I can just put some threshold point. So what I can do is just go to your HTML assertion. So I'm expecting, okay, so HTML can have five errors. Till five errors, I'm okay. And warning threshold, I'm just say 10 warnings. So till 10 warnings, that is okay. So if any errors we got below five or any warnings we got below 10, our assertion will pass. But if you are getting any errors more than five or warning messages more than 10, then again our assertion will fail. Okay, so this is called threshold point, error threshold point and warning threshold point. So save this and clear the old result. Then again, run our test plan. Now go to assertion results. Now this time everything is passed. So now I can go and see the response, go and see the other reports. So expand this and view results tree. And these are all the different requests we got it. Right, so here everything is goes well. And here everything is goes well. So everything is fine. So one more important feature we have here. Suppose it is basically finding the number of errors and a number of warnings, right? So, but if I want to see what are those errors or what are those warnings, I can just specify one text file here and all the warnings and errors will be logged into that particular file. We can clearly see those warnings and errors. So for example, here I'm just giving some file name. So in the E colon, so in the E drive somewhere, or just go to your E drive. So under E drive here, I will create a new text file. Just create a new text file. I'll say HTML result. So here I'll just browse that particular file here. So just click on the browse and go to E drive and select this file, open. So when I add this particular file, what happens is if any failures are occurred, any warnings are occurred in HTML, those failures will be logged into this particular file. So after adding this file, again save it, then clear the result, and again one more time I'm executing. So click on run. So again go to your assertion results. Now everything is passed, but we have specified the threshold point, right? So I am fine if we have less than five errors or less than 10 warnings. So let's see what are the warnings and errors messages we got from HTML. Let's go to E drive and it is created this file. If I open this particular file here, it will show you all the warnings. Okay, so this is the only one error we got it and six warnings we got it. So that's the reason HTML is not there in the proper format. It is clearly saying, right? So this is how we can just validate the HTML. So this is one of the assertion we have. So I'm just closing this. Fine, so that's all about HTML assertion. So the HTML assertion is used to check the HTML syntax of the response. Now we have another assertion called XML assertion. So the XML assertion is used to validate that the response follows a valid XML syntax. So here we will verify the XML format of the page. So sometimes the response will be there in XML format, and then we can go and use this particular assertion. So I'm just using this assertion. Let's see here. Go to JMeter again. So here what I can do is just go to plan. Now I'm adding another assertion. Go to assertions. And here I'm saying, I'm selecting XPath assertion. So select XML assertion, Select XML assertion. So here in the XML assertion, we no need to provide anything here. Just it will verify our response is having valid XML content or not. That's the only verification it will do. So I've just added this verification point and save it and clear old result and then execute it. So I'm just running the plan. Now go and see the assertion results. Now it is giving failure. See this? XML assertion, the entity copy was referenced but not declared. So that means our response is not properly having the XML format, or XML content is not properly aligned. So that's the reason our assertion is failure. If everything is fine in our XML file, then this particular XML will be passed. Okay, so if you are getting any XML response, then you can go and use this particular assertions. So for now, I'm just disabling this, or you can have it because this is failuring, right? So I'm just disabling. You can also disable certain assertion. If you don't want to execute certain assertions, you can just enable, or you can also disable as whenever you want. So for example, I want to disable this XML assertion. What I can do is right click here and you will see one option called disable. And this assertion will not execute at the runtime. In future, if you want to still execute this assertion, you can just again right click and you can enable it. Okay, so this is XML assertion. Right? This is a simple. It will verify the response is having proper XML document or not. If it doesn't have, it will fail. Or if everything is fine, the XML assertion will pass. And when we have to use this assertion, if your response is having some XML content, then you have to go and use this assertion. So the next one, I'll move on to the next assertion, that is XML schema assertion. So this is another type of assertion. Assertion, XML schema assertion. So the XML schema assertion is used to validate the response against a specified XML schema. So basically this particular XML schema assertion is almost similar to XML assertion, but in XML schema assertion, we'll verify the XML content, whatever response we got in XML format, that is exactly equal to our own XML format. We need to also pass one our file. We need to also pass our own XML schema file. So let me just show you here. So right click on the plan. So right click, add, go to assertions and take XML schema assertion. So here by default, it will verify the XML format, but here additionally, we need to browse a file here. We need to give some file name here. Schema file name, XML file name. Then it will exactly compare actual schema with expected schema. If both are same, then our assertion will pass, or else it will be fail. So there's a XML schema assertion. If you are getting any XML responses from your response, and then you will use these kind of assertions. So I'm also skipping this one for now. So if you have to verify any schema is correct or not, then you can go for this one. Next one, I can also disable this for now. Now let's move on to the next one. So then XPath assertion and JSON assertion. So XPath assertion is also very important. So the XPath assertion is used to validate the response using XPath expression. So for example, you got some response, you send some request and you got some response. In that particular response, you want to validate some node is present in the response or not. So simply, for example, I'm hitting this particular web page, right? So I'm just Orange HRM, this is a website I'm hitting. So as soon as I hit this URL, I'll get some HTML response. So on that particular response, this logo is also present, right? So I want to verify this particular logo is present on this page or not in my HTML response. So I can pass some XPath of this particular element, and then I can check it is present or not. So what I can do here is, go to your JMeter, and first of all, we need to capture XPath for this logo. So right click here, inspect. So once we inspected this logo, you will get the XPath. You can also copy like this, copy XPath, or you can just, you have any tools are there, so you can also copy XPath from here. So I'm just copying the XPath from here. Then go to your JMeter. So now I'm adding the XPath assertion. So right click on the plan, add, assertions, and go to XPath assertion. So here we need to verify this. Here we need to copy the XPath whatever you captured for that particular logo. So now it will verify exactly this particular XPath related logo here. This XPath is exactly pointing to the logo. So it is present on the response or not, it will be verified. So once we provided this XPath, and this is the XPath assertion, and provided, then what I can do is, so once we have done this, we can just save this. And once we have saved this, now we can just go and execute this. But before that, we need to do something else. So this will be validated properly only if XPath, like XML, if the page is having proper XML format. Otherwise, it will throw some error. So let's execute and see what kind of error it will throw. So let me just clear my old results. Now I'm running XPath assertion. So let's execute now. So go to your assertion results. Now it is getting failure. So because our response contains some invalid XML. So even we have verified with XML assertion earlier, right? So this XML assertion also sent the same kind of error. The entity copy was not referenced but not declared. That's the reason our XML assertion is failed sometime back. So now, because of the same reason, again, XPath assertion is also failed here, right? But whenever you want to verify some XPath, then XML format should be properly aligned. So to ignore these kind of errors, what I can do is go to your XPath assertion. You can just select one option called tolerant parser. So select this one, use TD of tolerant parser. So if you have any parser issues or processing issue in XML, that will be ignored. Now then it will verify exactly XPath related stuff is there in the response or not, it will verify. So I'm just selected this one and again save it, close the previous result, clear the previous result, and then I'll execute my plan one more time. Then go to your assertion results. Now this time it will pass. And even if you go to the result table, everything is passing. We use the result window. So here also pass result tree. Okay, so this is how we need to validate XPath. XPath assertion will verify this particular XPath is exactly present on the response or not. It will be verified. So that is how XPath assertion will be used. So the last one is JSON assertion. Sometimes some web pages will give you response in the JSON format, just like XML format. If the response is there in HTML or XML format, then we can directly use XPath assertion. Sometimes if the response is there in JSON format, then you can go and insert the JSON assertion. So where we have to specify the node name, JSON node name, and whether the particular node is present in the JSON response is present or not, it will be verified. When we need to use JSON assertion means if you have response in the JSON format and then you can go for this particular assertion. So how to add this assertion, just right click on the test plan, go to add, again assertion, and here you need to take the JSON assertion. It is just like XPath assertion. So if the format is if the response format is XML or HTML, then we go for XML assertion, XPath assertion. If the response is in JSON format, and then go for JSON assertion. So here again, we have to specify the JSON path. And then it will verify that particular node is available in the response or not, it will be verified. Okay. So this one we have to use only if you have any JSON response or not. Okay. So just I'm currently removing the dot. So this will exactly pointing to the complete page, that is our complete JSON format. But currently, whatever page I'm hitting, that will not return any JSON format of response, so that JSON assertion cannot be validated on that. But still, we can just say only dollar symbol here. It will also do something. So it will just verify the page. So here, save it. But this is not exact way of verification of JSON, right? So we have to get the proper JSON format and then we can do the validation. So for now, I'm just saving and clear the old result, and then I'm executing it. Select and execute this. Now just go to assertion results. Now everything goes well and passed. So, but we have to properly define the JSON request path there. So that's most important. So here we need to specify the JSON path. All right, so these are all most commonly used assertions in JMeter. So response assertion, size assertion, duration, HTML assertion, XML assertion, XML schema assertion, XPath assertion, and JSON assertions. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching this.